Pay attention and really understand that this shit is real. You know, I'm about to give it to you all lace and no chase. No sugarcoating, no nothing. For what a lot of dudes out there, they should be doing. You know, the so-called homies, the so-called everybody that you think really should be out there really listening to you and act like they care for you. Well, pay attention and listen to this. You know, I'm 25 years old, sitting here, sitting right now, sitting back up in Calipat. Now, you know, I'm not trying to speak no knowledge, but just give you real this game and understanding of really what this life is about. Now, you can sit around, you know, not do nothing, run around like you know everything and like you just got the world all in your hands. But believe me, it come a time to when you really gonna have to listen to somebody. So whether it be your mom, whether it be your dad, and if you ain't blessed with that, you know, my heart go out to you. Or whether it be, you know, the next person right there that you done looked up to and idolized your whole life, whether it's on TV, make-believe, in your mind, whatever the case may be. Do something successful. Be successful. Go to school. Focus. You know, if you ain't going to school, give it 100% in whatever it is you choose to do. But just don't half-step. Or else, you know, you'll be sitting here on the yard in the penitentiary system or in somebody else's system wondering why. That'd be the whole key. Why? Why I didn't do this? Why I didn't listen? Why? Why? Why and why? Why everybody else is just sitting there living your life? Because believe me, when you behind these walls, you dead to pretty much everyone. And you only have a few friends, few loved ones that really, really care for you. Now, this ain't no rehearsed speech or nothing, you know. And I'm really blessed, all in so many ways. You know, I'm one of the fortunate ones, you know, that actually get a chance to come back and live life. You know, I grew up out of there, out of Southeast San Diego. Now, you know, like I said, this shit ain't no rehearsed speech. So pay attention. Out of Southeast San Diego, right there off of the Brands neighborhood, off of Ocean View and 38th. Yeah, that's me. And I done been fortunate. I done pretty much did everything underneath the sun and over the moon. Everything there is when it comes to a certain way of living that life on the streets. Everything. And I done been blessed to have a second chance at life.
So you're getting out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you got a time to get out, which a lot of guys around here don't have all this time.
Yeah.
And you got put in here with guys that don't have time to get out.
Yeah.
Because of the depth of the crime
3 years.
And stuff.
3 years left. You know, while I'm sitting here with dude with 70, 45 grandpas, uncles, brothers, you know, 19, 20, with no time, with man, unbelievable time that I can't even fathom doing. Time that I don't even want to try to fathom, but...
A bunch of guys that have nothing to lose and you get put in with them and...
But you know, the whole politics system, it's a system filled for an animal. Just think about how you raise an animal, a dog. A dog. Think about yourself as a dog and everybody else that's got you on the leash, you know. You're surrounded by a group of a structure of people that holds you onto a leash, telling you when to eat, when not to eat, closing the cage cell, go into your cell, feeding you food on the plate, on a tray. Can you imagine that? You living in a bathroom. Can you really imagine that? Do you really want that type of life? Now, if you do, I mean, don't listen. And then you will see. You'll see. But like I said, I'm not trying to preach. I'm just trying to give you the understanding of life that is real. So just pay attention to the loved ones and the truth that they be telling you. You know, when they be saying do good, and sometimes we be feeling like, you know, we may need an extra little bit of elaboration. Well, you take the step within yourself to make sure that you asking the right questions. And then, if you felt that they ain't giving you the right answers, then try asking somebody else. They're all shaped, you know. There is a higher being. There is a God. But I'm not about to get all holy and all spiritual. Just understand that this ain't a place that you want to be, you know. Baby, I love you. My wife, my lovely, beautiful wife, Miss Martha Schultz, I love you, woman. Know that. All my family out there, I love you. Just know, I'll be home soon. Time is ticking. Y'all just stay focused out there. I'm focused up in here. All right.